Now, the level of things that we would see as labels, our nationality, for instance, our sex, our sexuality, our religion, our ethnicity, our culture, these are to be honored. We talk here about honoring our incarnation. But from A Course in Miracles perspective, that level of our reality, which would deem us separate from anyone else. I'm white, you're black. I'm a woman, you're a man. I'm an American, you're an Indian, whatever. By definition, is not the deepest level of our reality. It's not that those things are not to be honored, and it's not that those things are not to be appreciated, and it is not that those things are not to be thought about very deeply in many of the decisions that we make about our life on earth. However, from A Course in Miracles perspective, the issue is to deepen our emotional ground of being. You know, the Course in Miracles says that spirituality and psychotherapy, well, it says religion and psychotherapy at their peak are the same thing, because they have to do with the healing of the mind. And that healing of the mind has to do with the emotional center of gravity being based on a mental filter that is basically our experience of the world as evidenced by the physical senses. And it's the physical senses that would lead me to see myself as separate from you, therefore my color, my ethnicity, and so forth, is deemed to make you separate from me. My mental filter changes. The real spiritual journey, which is the real meaning of the religious journey, not in an exoteric sense of doctrine and institution and dogma, but in the internal esoteric sense of the changes within our hearts and the journey within our heart, from the head to the heart. That is one in which we shift the mental filter. And in shifting the mental filter, you can actually feel it within your body. We know, you know, sometimes we can feel when we're spinning out. Somebody will say, "You're spinning out." Or a term that sometimes people will say these days, "You're leaking. Your energy is kind of all over the place." Somebody will say, "Your energy is all over the place." And we seek to be centered within ourselves. And we seek to be centered within ourselves because when I am centered within myself, I am centered not simply in my mind, but in my mind when it is encased, as it were, within my spirit. Now, if my mental filter is only that in which I base my sense of reality on what my physical senses tell me, then by definition, I will see myself as separate from you. Now, there's a line in The Course in Miracles where it says, all of us feel alien here. And the reason you feel like an alien on this plane is because you are. The mindset that dominates this planet is a mindset of separation. And because it is a mindset that posits us as separate from each other, by definition, we feel fear here. The spirit is not at home in fear. The spirit is at home in love, because the spirit is love. So when we drop, and this is what a spiritual journey is, this is why we meditate, this is why we pray, we are taking what The Course in Miracles calls the journey without distance. From the head to the heart. The emotional center of gravity deepens. You feel this when you've meditated. You feel this when you forgive. We've all been there. The issue isn't that we haven't been there. The issue is, how do we get there more often? That's the issue here. The issue is not traveling to a place where none of us have ever been. We're talking about traveling to a place that all of us have been to, but making it the rule rather than the exception, which too often it is now. And we go to that other place, and in that other place, even the word place refers to, you know, look at the language there. Time and space are a description of reality as evidenced by physical senses. But Einstein said time and space are part of the illusions of consciousness. And certainly The Course in Miracles would agree with that. In the real world is not evidenced by time and space. Time and space are themselves not real. We move into this quantum space, and in that quantum space, two issues about the quantum space. The quantum space is one in which you and I are not separate. You and I are dwelling in spirit, so that when you are at the deepest place within you, and that you are the deepest place within you, and you are the deepest place within you, and I'm in the deepest place within me, we do not experience ourselves as separate. Because love has replaced our fear.